This hero power does a really good job of making up for Paladin's weaknesses. Okay, I think I just go for like the most expensive cards I can. Modest Aspiration just seems really good in the deck. I like how I was thinking so much there. I don't think altogether now will work with Humble Blessings. So it might just be Dragonblood. Which I've actually found is somewhat useful. These are both okay. Yeah, the Dragon Consort will work. Assuming you play it, like, after Humble Blessing. But honestly, it's kind of worthless. It's a 3 mana 3/3, which after Humble Blessings is pretty bad. A 3 mana 3/3 make your next card potentially cost 1. Like Amber Watcher is okay because it's like a defensive Alexstrasza. Red Scale is good. Of these, only Tyrion is good. So I think we can go Menagerie. And it is hard to fill in the curve at times because everything costs 3.
Turalyon versus Rattlegore.
The light has forsaken you.
Just start with Runic Egg. Tough. They have so many ways to gain armor now that the armor vendor in turn 1 makes life so difficult. It just feels like they get to keep, like, have infinite armor. The rocket backpack is just insane as well. Okay. I have to kill that. Maybe I'm supposed to bump heal there. Dragonblood, whenever a dragon dies, give other friendly minions +1/+1.
Just keep moving.
Here for a good time. Here for a good time.
Hello, air hater.
Unity, precision, perfection.
Okay. I think I'm just dead next turn no matter what. I mean, if I don't draw a bomb, there's a chance, but holy smokes.
Savor your victory.
I've been struggling with Mage. It's very complicated. I should probably lower it on my tier list. I've played Mage some, but the Quest Mage is really hard to play. And I actually think this Paladin would just crush it. It might be better now. Let's try Worshipper. The Holy Spell. These guys do stuff. They changed Infinite Arcane basically like a week after they figured out how it was pulling actual C'Thun. They changed it, like, right away. It was like a week later.
I will savor this victory.
Like, literally the next patch.
No more pranks.
I do think it, like, I've seen some people complain about that, and I'm like, you realize they changed it, like, right away. How are you unaware of this? I mean, a lot of duels is manipulating. Like, it's just, I think that getting your passives as early as you do, increases the volatility. But, do I think that there's too much? I don't think I would go that far. Oh, you're right. Playing the Crab Rider would have been better. You're right. That's fair. That's my fault. My mulligan, I had the egg, and then I started talking, and I completely forgot about everything else in the world.
Put your faith in the light.
It happens when streaming. Like, basically, if I'm having to give thought to an answer in a question, my play is on auto mode. Auto. So now I'm clearing here, and it's like, why even bother? I think Hunter is close to having two classes. Like, the secret package is actually playable. What else? Do I even bother with this for 5 damage? Sure. I don't like Shaman very much. I don't think Shaman has, like, any, like, good decks. Please don't have fun. Blessing. That's almost as bad. Humble Blessing, like, and we're almost dead. I can also make it so he's almost dead. Like, basically, Bearer of Consecration is the only thing he can do. Basically, I would flip Rogue and Paladin. Avenging Armaments is pretty good. Scepter of Summoning kind of makes the deck playable without the Humble Blessing. So maybe we go there. The thing is, it's like we're playing without a passive half the time. But, Avenging Armaments is awesome. We just don't have it. Like, you need, like, the first Divine Shield passive as well. Well then. Well, that's a holy spell. That's a holy spell. That's a holy spell. So, we take not the holy spell.
Forsaken you.
Does anyone know how Dragon Consort works with Scepter of Summoning? Is Mage tier 2? I think I just leave. I think I'm just gonna have everything be tier 3. I currently have 7 classes in tier 3. I had Kazakus in, but what do you recommend taking out? I enjoyed Kazakus, but I was having issues with it. That moment when they realized Dragonblood. Bistain, thanks for following. It was at this moment he realized he fucked up. My staff of scales is, I think it's just like super easy choice there. Yeah, like, I was having issues keeping my deck free of 4 drops. I did like Kazakus, it was just, I felt that the other cards have been more impactful. But Kazakus was a ton of fun, because you take the 10 cost one and you get to drop it for 3 mana, it was pretty sick. Well, no, if you play Humble Blessings before Kazakus, then it's always active because you don't have any 4-cost cards. Unless you take True Silver Champion, which doesn't change its cost. And is very frustrating.
No more pranks.
The light dims, but we fight.
So they've had mirrored phrases. Or like they've had phrases that are meant for each other. I stopped paying attention to what they say though. It's pretty cool though. Like they had voice lines set up for every matchup, including the mirrors. But yeah, every other patch breaks them. Hello, Johnny. You shouldn't sexualize streamers, though. Holy smokes. I mean, I'll do more runs today. I'm not just doing this one run today. That's a very stupid play by him. I might have even had lethal if I counted. Or no, I would have needed to kill it anyway. But maybe there was a lethal. That's fine. No worries. But yeah, no, I haven't been streaming that. I am not streaming tomorrow. But yeah, I'll be streaming for like another at least 4 hours probably. Yeah, schedule kick W. I typically do polls for the class once I can see what class they are. I have been obliterated on stream before. I do drinking streams time to time. I don't really drink that often. Because I don't really enjoy it that much, but I'll drink to like get drunk once in a while. But I don't enjoy casually drinking. I'm between Mage Armor and Hilt. Let's go Hilt. LCS, thank you so much for gifting a sub over to Air Hater. Or should I say, fuck you, LCS? Gifting a sub over to Air Hater. My bad. Let's see. I could just take the loot hoarder. Whoa. Yeah, I know. He's not used to it. But that's you literally told me to be rude to you. You can't make me feel bad. Well, you can, but it's gonna take more than that.
Considering a career in teaching?
The light dims.
Don't beg LCS for money, Feku. Very unbecoming. I know from experience. In begging people for money. Well, because if you go 0-3 on stream, the 0-3 come and shut down your stream. The 0-3 police come and they shut down your stream. It's not allowed. Rancor is in like all of my warrior decks now. I may keep forgetting to post my most recent warrior deck though. Obviously, you're only allowed to stream if you're the best player, obviously. Well, that was probably we'll see how this goes. Goodbye, Fekko.
These old bones just keep moving.
-25k. Oh, he already messed up, chat. It was in that moment. He realized how powerful Dragonblood was. Oh, man. These people, I don't understand. How do they keep messing this up? That is, Dragonblood is just so rare.
Yikes! Time for summer break.
I have a 12-win run, I believe, with Dragonblood. Let's see, we've got dragons. Beasts, dragons, mech, murloc. Deathwing Dragonlord is actually kind of bad some of the time. I guess 3-mana Zilliax would be pretty good. Oh yeah, and I have the Elementals. N'Zoth of the Deep. Might be okay enough. It's between this and this. It's fine, like, Deathwing Dragonlord is okay pre-Humble Blessings, but post-Humble Blessings, it's actually pretty true.
Turalion versus Slate!
Ooh, I get to fight the great Turalion. How invigorating!
Ha ha, Professor Slate, this will be a battle of wits.
That's a really good draw. I mean, outside of the Knight of Anointment that is hiding every game. You guys remember when he had 38 health to start the turn? And then on turn 4 I did 32 damage? Nazari is really good. Imagine a turn where you play Nazari and Alex on their face at the same time. I think it's no more plays, but if someone thinks that Nazari is good enough, I'm open to discussion. Because it's a 5-mana Nazari, and if someone's like burning me down, it could save me. EMC LSD, thank you so much for the 3 months. Glad you still enjoy. Thank you so much for the support. How are you doing? Oh, Grita, thanks for following. I don't know why that's not showing up on Twitch. There we go. The alert was like super delayed for Twitch.
Considering a career in teaching.
To Onyxia.
What is it now?
Oh, that is unfortunate. That's a lot of damage. I don't know if we'll live long enough. No, there's not a prediction going. I'll start a prediction for 12 wins. Sure, 12 wins. Predict. Okay, well, he messed up already. Or did he? Because he only had 5 damage.
I didn't think of that.
No, you didn't think about how you were dead. Alexstrasza, fair and balanced. No one respects Dragonblood. I think Staff of Skills is actually really good post-Humble Blessing. I think I'll hold on to it. Stargazing. Only 30 seconds left to bet on if the run goes 12 wins. Chat, you notice anything new in my deck that the deck tracker appears to have found? So that was nice of our previous opponent to give us. So our previous opponent had Quel'Delar in their deck, and usually when you beat someone with a completed Quel'Delar, It ends up in your deck.
Be quick.
I got this.
I mean, I do make some guides. I'll have a Humble Blessing guide. I have a Quest Rogue guide, but it's a little outdated. The issue with the guides is that every patch they get outdated. And it takes me time to gain enough understanding with a patch to be able to play it well enough. So, it just takes time. All of my minions are 3 mana. They're all 3 mana 3/3s because of my starting treasure Humble Blessings. Well, no, you're supposed to get Quel'Dalar when you beat someone with it. Like, you're supposed to. It's a bug if you don't get it. Sometimes when you beat some, like, I've been beaten by Quel'Dalar and then got it. I think that was a bug, and I think they have fixed that. Well, the priest can heal quite a bit and draw quite a bit. So we're gonna need some card draw at some point, most likely. Because, like, Rag at 3/3 is not as imposing. Oh, it looks like he was gonna Shadow Word Pain it. Or what is that spell? Is it just the, okay. I thought it might be Holy Smite. After his hesitation. I will say, the behavior of Quel'Dalar is not the most consistent. That's actually terrifying, because his cards are, the cards in my deck are 3 cost already.
I got this.
If you keep one, it disappears, and then it goes... The first game, Zalay, he had both pieces in his starting hand. They disappear, it assembles Quel'Dalar, and then Quel'Dalar is in his hand. But he didn't have any cards to play then. So he ended up losing. This is Qualdalar. I guess I should have attacked with my face into it. So this isn't great. At all. I'd even go as far to say that this is super bad. I only denied him like 8 health there with the Aedric. Still 8 health though. Now he's full of cards. Yeah, and I kept a minion alive, so that's helpful. And then that's 9. Let's see, that's lethal. We got 10 on board plus 8 from the weapon. Part of me is a little upset that he was able to fight back for any amount of time. That's a holy spell. Or it's not a holy spell. Do I want card draw? Those are pretty bad. I think I take the card draw.
It's time for a little blood.
I mean, I still get Qualdalar.
May the light grant
you peace. Oh, fuck. Oh, they really changed Assassin's Blade up. Is that only 4 mana now? Yeah. So I could play Humble Blessing. Or I could kill his board. It's pretty good in this matchup. The sword. Had only turn 3 Humble Blessings, but he also had goggles. He gave up quite quickly. You don't fuck with Quell the Large. No more.
Versus plate. I like it.
A friendly match then, Instructor Fireheart.
Nothing scares me, except mice.
Our poor faces. So I think I like a defensive like coin staff of skills like I did last game. Into the Alex Quildler.
Shall we make a storm?
Oh, come on.
I bring life.
We've been having Alex. Well, I mean, I'm keeping it in the mole again. But we've had it really consistently. He played a Dreamgrove Ring, which is choose a legendary, summon 5 copies of it, but he died luckily before we. I mean, if we didn't kill him that turn, we die. Probably Bubba. I think you can get two Qualdalars in your deck.
A career in teaching.
I thought. I don't think there's any cap on him. But I'm pretty sure Paradox is talking about penises and not swords. Okay.
Job done.
Captured flag token, Druid. Nothing to see here. Can I even play Tyrion? I probably want to use up all of my Qualdalar charges. The issue is Qualdalar is only 32 damage. We're still missing 8 base damage.
Scares me.
Okay, we only need 2 more face damage and him to not heal at all and be able to attack his face 4 turns in a row. His auth summons nothing so far, by the way. We have had no minion types die. Now I'm even miss the face damage with this. He was hand tracking, he should have known it was a possibility. Humble Blessings is really, really, really good. Oh yeah, that's true. I can just rely on the Tyrion sword eventually. He's healing, but heal is cheat. Healing is cheating. Okay, so I'm gonna refund your points, Faku. LCS donates too much. I'll give him immunity. Thank you. killing the dragon first. Now that's a play. LCS gifting a tier 3 god sub to Feku-san. God sub. Okay, so we probably want to kill that.
Put your faith in the light.
And then I'll just play these guys. You thought we had a problem? How could you think we have a problem? We have a hero power that just makes it so it's like, oh, you have a big minion? Nope. Nope. I mean, if he had some way of preventing us from attacking his face here, maybe I could see us being in a little trouble. Because we were only at 20 life. Yeah, I just don't have a screenshot of it.
Oh, hi, Professor Duralian.
Are you considering
it's a different person. I think I can keep Anixia. It's a pretty good 5 drop. I'll ditch these cards, though. I mean, first day of school can give knight. It can also not give knight. I guess we actually, like, our first goal is honestly just to survive till turn 6. He's making all of my Scepter of Summoning cards cost 6.
I'm meeting a friend.
He is a monster chat. Okay, we're actually getting absolutely shredded. So we just have to take it for 2 turns, chat. I mean, he can only put so much more damage on his board. Most of the time. So what, we're taking 10 damage a turn, we'll be at... We should stabilize around 15 health.
Thank you.
Oh wait, yeah, no, this can't attack. We actually have a little bit more health.
This is not what we stood for. It seems you need another lesson. Come forth, my
friend. Is he aware, chat? Is he aware? I mean, honestly, I don't know what he does, regardless, but... I mean, he seems to have most of the information. Hello, Hobbs. You didn't think about the fact that you just destroyed your hand. I mean, I wouldn't say good game yet. Sticky fingers might be pickable in buckets, which would actually destroy us. I don't actually know if I've ever seen a sticky fingers, though. Make our board stronger. He took one power off the board with his destroy a minion spell. He's counting. Technically not dead on board. But he doesn't know. Die, insect. Twelve wins? If you're watching on YouTube, please be sure you like, subscribe, comment with do you think this is the most OP deck in the meta? You can check out my Discord for deck lists and watch me every day on twitch.tv/TeamAmerica. Thanks for watching.